Well, we can speak now to Blair Barnett, who's an art director and production designer, and she joins me now from East London via webcam. Hello, good afternoon to you. So great news for many people that cinemas can gradually open up in 10 days' time, but you'll have had a difficult time during lockdown, won't you, because you're freelance. So what's the impact been on you?
It's been very challenging in the fact that, like you said, I'm freelance and all of the work that comes through is contract based. It all dried up immediately as soon as we went into lockdown. And I just can't see when it's going to come back with any sort of impact like we had before. It could come in drips and drabs, but it's going to be a long time before we're working steadily like we were just a few months ago.
So have you had any work in this time?
I've done some of my own projects off of my own back. I'm also a director, and I've created a show here in my house and filmed it. But it's not paid work, but it does. It is creating content and something that keeps me creative, keeps me interesting, and hopefully I can do something with it later on.
So that's great, and it keeps your brain working. But in terms of paid employment, it's not that.
No, it is definitely not that.
How long do you think it's going to be until things start moving again?
Well, I've seen some things posted, little jobs here and there, but I am worried about being able to social distance and work with a responsible way, all on top of each other. I still think there's a long way to go before we're really able to safely do that. So the amount of productions that are coming out will be fewer than before, because it is a learning curve for us to all figure this out. And even when we do start working, oftentimes it's months before we're paid. Even in the best of times, sometimes it took up to 90 days or even longer for me to get paid as a freelancer. So even if I start working right now, it's going to be a while before I have a steady income.
And you mentioned at the beginning that you lost 4 contracts as lockdown started. I mean, what did that mean for you financially?
It was a loss of £38,000. All of those phone calls came in within 1 hour on Friday the 13th. Every time I picked up the phone, it was another job postponing. But the income that I would have had through all of those contracts, had I finished the work, would have been £38,000. And that's a substantial amount of my income, if not most of it, that just gone within an hour. And I've never been in this position before where you're having to really get creative to figure out how you can work your household, how you can pay your bills. Nobody was expecting this, and nobody knew how to react to it. It's challenging for millions of us.
Yes, no, I can hear that. What do you feel when you think about the future, the next 6 months, for example, or the next 2 years? Are you hopeful?
Yes, but there's a double-edged sword with this. I try to be a very positive person and look at reinventing and looking at new ways of doing things and to never be a victim or never be demoralized by a situation. There's always an answer to something. And I feel that there is going to be there's a lot of creativity coming out of this and a lot of new ways of looking at things, new ways of achieving the same results. Like a lot of people are working at home, all these jobs that said, no, you can't possibly work at home. Well, the same job can obviously be done at home. So there will be some new ways of working and doing things that are out there, which is great. As a side effect, this is very strange. Like all of the hugging and tactileness that happens a lot on film sets, which I've never been very comfortable with, I feel like now that's going to be taken off the table, so you don't have to hug all the guys that you always feel like you have to hug. All the times you're looking at the monitor and a guy comes up next to you like, all right, what you doing? What you looking at? What can I do for you? It's like, that's going to not happen anymore. So that's actually a really positive thing. I don't think that's been really talked about much, but I've thought about that. But I'm really hoping that we will come together. I mean, we're inventors, we're creatives. We can find a way around this and be able to tell stories. And the stories and the perspectives that we have, there's going to be so many more stories that are to be told. New things. It's a new nowness that we can talk about. Yes. And even there are evergreen stories that will transpire outside of this, but we have a moment in history that's going to be the impetus for many stories.
Yes,
and
I'm
a lot
sure.
of creative, Yeah,
yes,
a lot
lovely.
of creative.
We're going to
Yes.
have to leave it there, Blair. Very good to talk to you, and good luck with whatever is to come. Thank you so much.
Thank you
Blair
very
Barnett,
much.
thank you.